Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Welcome to part 2 of this series on the 2-5-1 chord progression. In this part, we are going to look at how to actually play it on the piano in a very piano-friendly and also a harmonically rich sounding way, where the voicings are very open, spread out and very jazzy. Okay, so make sure you stick around till the end because we are going to look at all the possible options. It's a rather detailed lesson, and also I'm going to show you this progression and the voicing pattern on both the major scale as well as the minor scale. Sometimes we forget to look at the minor, but the minor is also used in a lot of popular music as well as classical music, jazz standards, and even film music. So let's get started right away. We have the 2-5-1 chord progression first of all to deal with, and we are playing it in an extended version. What I mean by that is the 2 is not played as a minor chord. It's played as a minor 7th chord. Okay, and why am I playing A minor? I should have told you that earlier. I'm in the key of G major, where A is the 2 minor 7th chord, okay? And then we go to the 5. It's a 2-5-1 chord progression. So the 2 will be A minor 7th, which is the 7th note. Then the 5 will be D, which is the dominant chord. D, F sharp, A, C. Okay? And then end on the G major 7th. Voicing. Okay. The 2-5-1 chord progressions used very commonly in jazz. It's come from the major scale, but now playing it is a bit maybe messy or muddy, and it's also tough, especially for a beginner. When I started learning this, I found it really tough because I've had to go from triads, which is just 3 notes, to now 4 notes, which is now sort of making the movement of my fingers a little bit more tricky. Right? So there's a nice voicing technique which you could learn. I'm going to share 2 voicing techniques with you guys. Okay? And if you haven't already, head over to part 1 where I discuss the theory of all this stuff. Okay? In some cases, for some of you, you may be having a few doubts of what is a minor 7th chord, what is a major 7th chord, and so on and so forth. All this is covered in part 1. So head over there and check that out, and then you can always come back to this lesson. So if I have to play this on the piano, I just need to look at intervals. The intervals of any of these chords are going to be 1, 3, 5, and 7. Okay? Now, a good way to voice it will not be to play it as 1, 3, 5, 7. You could play it in a kind of a jumbled way, which makes the sound open. So I'm going to give you 2 voicing techniques in this lesson. I'm going to give you 1, 5, 7, 3. Then I'm going to give you 1, 5, 3, 7. It's a bit more stretched out, okay? And while you learn this, we need to learn it for all the chord qualities. We'll have to learn it for the minor 7th chord. We'll have to learn it for the dom 7, then the major chord, and the minor scale. We also have to learn it in the minor 7 flat 5 chord, okay? So in the key of G major, the 2-5-1 is going to be A minor 7th, D dominant 7th, and G major 7th. Okay, so let's break down each of these chords. A minor 7th contains the notes A, C, E, G. How am I voicing this? The 1 and the 5, I'm going to play in my left hand. Okay, and then the 3 and the 7, I'm going to play in my right hand. 1, 5, 3, 7. Of course, it's a 3 flat and a 7 flat, because in a minor 7th chord, the 3 is flat and the 7th is flat. Okay? So A, E, C, G. Very open, right? As opposed to playing it like that, which is very muddy, or even like this. So left hand A plus E plus C plus G. Okay, so that's your 2 minor 7th chord in the G major scale. Moving on to the 5 dominant 7th chord. The 5 dominant 7th chord is going to be D7th. Okay, and what's the left hand rule for this lesson? Always play fifths. That means root, fifth. And now check out the right hand. My right hand has already played CG. And I want to make it kind of easy for myself to go to the D dominant chord. So what can we consider? I could do D here, move up there. And then C is already common, right? C is already there for the D dominant 7th chord. So I can look at a voicing like this, which is 1, 5, 7, 3. Actually, in this case, in the dominant 7th chord, it's 7 flat. 1, 5, 7 flat, 3. So repeat. 1, 5, 3 flat, 7 flat for A minor 7th. Then 1, 5, 7 flat, 3 for D dominant 7th. And you see that shift. In my right hand, at least, it's just one finger. C to G. And then C to F sharp. So this is the A minor 7th chord. A minor 7th. And this is the D dominant 7th chord. So far, in simple words, I hope I'm going to make it even more simpler. You take a 5th chord in the bass, A, E. And then either do a 3-7 voicing, which in this case is C, G. Or else do a 7-3 voicing in the right hand with respect to that chord. So if it's a minor 7th, it's going to be flat 3, flat 7. If it's going to be a dominant 7th chord, it will be 3 normal and 7 flat. If it's a major 7th chord, 3 major, 7 major. And if it's a minor 7 flat 5 chord, it's going to be flat 3, flat 5 and flat 7. Okay, so you need to remember what are the notes of these chords. Write them down and then you figure out the voicing technique, which from left to right is going to be 1, 5 and then 7-3 or else 3-7, depending on the chord. So let's just look at the next chord, A minor 7th, A, E, C, G. And now it goes to D dominant, D, A, C, F sharp. Okay, and see how smoothly it's led. And the last chord is going to be G major 7th. Now in G major 7th, you have F sharp, which is already common. I just have to slide the C down to B and you get a nice open G major 7th sound right there. And this, one might say, is a 3-7 voicing. So A minor 7th in 3-7, D dominant 7th in 7-3 because it's easy to play, and then G major 7th in 3-7. Okay. So try this out. Play every chord. Play A minor 7th for 2 beats. 1, 2. D dominant for 2 beats. And G major 7th for maybe 4 counts. Or if you want to take your time even more, do it 4, 4 and 2 bars of the last chord. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next bar. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or you could do it quicker, change two beats each in the first two chords. 2, 3, 4. 1. Whole bar for G. A minor 7th, D dominant. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so right now I started with 3-7. Of A minor 7th. Now I'll do 7-3. Okay. So that's A, E, G, C. What did I do earlier? C, G. Now G, C. So I'm going to do this again. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. And those are your three chords. And they sound really good, even very low on the keyboard, right? Okay, that's the major 7th chord. Or you could take it high if you'd like. Okay. Sounds good pretty much everywhere on the keyboard, right? 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. Let's try it a bit lower now. 2, 3, 4. I quite like the lower version. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and that's pretty much it. So you have two exercises for every 2-5-1 chord progression, which you need to do, and it'll really equip you well while playing a multitude of songs, really, because the 2-5-1 chord progression is really popular. It's used in almost every jazz standard, at least. It's used in gospel, it's used in soul, R&B, you know, funk, jazz, blues, everything, right? So get used to the shape, and it's a very useful go-to shape. So shape 1, shape 2. Okay, now I told you I'm not going to stop here. I'm also going to show you how you form the minor 2-5-1. In the minor 2-5-1, we derive the chords as 2 minor 7 flat 5, right? If this doesn't make sense to you, head over to part 1 where we break this chord down in detail. Now, a minor 7 flat 5 is the second chord of the harmonic minor scale or the minor scale in general. So I'm building it off there. So if I do the 2, it's A diminished plus the 7th. Okay, A minor 7 flat 5. Then again you get the usual 5-7, which is D dominant. And then instead of resolving to a 1 major 7th, which we did for the major scale, you resolve to a 1 minor 7th. But the voicing patterns remain pretty much the same, right? It's going to be 7-3 in some way there and 1-5 in some way here, right? So if I take the first chord, A minor 7 flat 5, that's A, C, E flat, G. Okay, E flat, actually speaking, is a tritone. It's not a perfect fifth. So I can't do this in my bass. I have to do that, which is the tritone. And then in the right hand, I can decide whether I want to do CG, sounds beautiful, or you could do GC. So CG, GC. And now if I have to go to the next chord, so if I do CG, and now if I have to do D dominant from there, it's quite easy. A minor 7 flat 5, going to D dominant 7th, which is here. And then you end with G minor 7th, which is the root home minor. A minor 7 flat 5, D dominant 7th, and you drop it down to G minor 7th. So this is the minor 2-5-1. It's a lot in blues, actually, right? Okay, and the other shape, instead of doing CG, I can do GC, which is the 7-3 voicing, and then dominant D, minor 7G. One more time. Next, D minor 7th. So minor 2-5-1. I'd go higher. Okay, and it's nice if you can practice this on as many scales as possible. I've written it down for you guys on F major and F minor, so you could try to revisit the same concepts and the same voicing techniques using some other scales. And I've written all this down in a PDF file, which you could download on our Patreon page. So do head over there and also perhaps support our channel. It'll be awesome. So in conclusion, in this lesson, we've looked at voicing patterns for 2-5-1 progressions, major as well as minor. In the major scale, the voicing pattern is going to be always 1-5 in the left hand, Even in the minor scale, you do 1-5 in the left hand. In the right hand, you decide whether you want to do 3-7 or 7-3. And then you have to write it down so that you know whether it's 7-3 of one chord going to the 3-7 of the next chord, or staying on 3-7 or staying on 7-3, depending on the chord progression. So pretty much any extended chord or any seventh chord can be played in this open voicing, which is 1-5-7-3 or 1-5-3-7, where the 7 and the 3 could either be major 7th or minor 7th. And the 5 in one case in the diminished chord or the minor 7 flat 5 will be a flat 5. Okay, so now we move over to part 3, where we are going to do an incredible Latin rhythm pattern which I have for you, where we are going to just basically take the same voicing technique and we are going to build a really cool Latin rhythm which is going to improve your independence on the piano. We are going to look at 16th notes and get to a lot of groovy stuff which is coming up in the next part. So head over to part 3. And again, thanks for watching this lesson. If you haven't already, do hit the subscribe button and the turn on the bell button for notifications. Thanks again. Cheers. See you in part 3.